Thank you, friends, for showing your love to my videos on IT career roadmap and cybersecurity career roadmap. And obviously, there were a lot of requests to make a video on DevOps career roadmap. So here we are. We'll understand what you need to get started, and what you need to learn to become a DevOps professional. It could be a DevOps engineer or a DevOps architect. So to understand this whole DevOps journey, I have divided it into three phases. Like in history, we used to have BC and AD. In a similar way, I have three different phases. BD, which is before DevOps, DD, which is during DevOps, and PD, which is post DevOps. So we'll understand what you need before you start your journey in DevOps, what you would need to learn during your journey, and what you need to continue to do once you get into a DevOps career. So even before starting DevOps, there are certain basic concepts which you need to learn as an IT professional. The number one is SDLC, which is Software Development Lifecycle. How a software is developed, the whole journey of getting the requirements, building the software, testing it, deploying it, all that you should be able to do it without DevOps, just on a legacy platform, just with a plain simple Hello World application. Can you do that without automating anything? If you know that, or you are already having that basic understanding of the whole software development lifecycle, so that is very important. And with that comes the tricky part, which is the knowledge of any one coding language. I think you need to know that in DevOps, it's important. It could be, you could start with Python, which is a very simple language, but you need to have some basic understanding of how programming works, how coding works. The second one is understanding the operating systems, because obviously you would be spinning up a lot of infrastructure and all. And for that, you need to understand Linux and Windows very well. And especially you need to understand the CLIs. So what is CLI? CLI is command line interface. So you need to understand the CLIs better so that you could write scripts, you could automate stuff without going into the graphical user interface. For example, you could write scripts on PowerShell. So all those kind of CLIs you need to learn. Networking. Now this channel has grown based on the videos we have made on networking. So if you are completely beginner, you could go and check out our networking and infra playlist. It starts with the very basic, and you would definitely get something out of it. But you need to know what is an IP address, how OSI model works, what kind of different protocols are there, how it works, DNS, all kind of things. But don't get stuck on these things, okay? Even if you have a little knowledge, just try to move ahead. Don't get stuck into that mindset that no, unless I become an expert, I can't go into DevOps. You just need basics. Scripting, as I said, is very important, using Bash, Python, PowerShell. You need to automate a lot of stuff in DevOps. And for that, you need to have scripting knowledge. Infrastructure basics, how a virtual machine works, what is virtualization, what is containers, how database storage works, all those kind of things. And obviously, last but not the least, cloud computing, because everything which you are seeing on the top sits right now on this bedrock of cloud computing. Everything has moved to cloud, so you need to know the basic fundamentals of cloud. If you want me to create a video on cloud computing basics, let me know and I'll try to refresh that for you in some other video. So if you are done with this, if you're confident that, and when I say confident, if on a scale of 10, even if you are a 4 or 5, don't wait, you are ready. Just move to the DD stage, which is during DevOps. So friends, now let's understand what we will understand and learn during our DevOps journey. Now, don't get overwhelmed by so many things because obviously DevOps is quite vast, and that's why I always say you need not to be a 9 out of 10 expert in all of these things, okay? You could have your own niche in either of these things, and then you could learn the overall DevOps framework to become a DevOps architect or a DevOps engineer. But you need to know at least 6 out of 10 or 7 out of 10 in most of these. So the number one is the concept. What is a DevOps concept? How CI/CD works? What is CI? What is continuous integration? What is continuous deployment? All these kind of concepts, and why we need to build DevOps culture. All that will be covered as your step one. If you're joining any course, generally this would be the structure. In the second step, you will start getting into the nitty-gritties of how DevOps actually works. So the number one thing is version control. whenever developers are developing the code, they need to maintain the version of their code into some repository, and that's where you need code repositories like Git or Bitbucket, for example. So in these code repositories, you can, you know, merge your code, take a branch out of your existing code which is there, and multiple developers could collaborate on a single functionality or a single module. And that's why your version control system becomes so important. So you need to learn, understand, and implement version control. So the third step in this journey is to understand how continuous integration and build automation works. Basically, in DevOps, you're automating everything which you do as a developer, as a tester, as a support engineer. Everyone works together, but no one does things manually to the max possible. So build automation and continuous integration basically means that you need to set up your pipeline, DevOps pipeline, in a way where the moment you push a code into your Git repository, automatically the new build get triggered, then the test cases, the unit test cases and integration test cases are all automated and should run automatically. So that is the whole process of continuous integration. And once you have integrated the code, then you do the CD part, which is continuous delivery or continuous deployment. There's a difference between the two, but we'll not go into that detail now. I have created a small video on that, so you can watch that as well. But understand that build automation and continuous integration is the 50% of your whole DevOps pipeline. Jenkins is a very important tool. As I said, there are tools which could be used at multiple layers. So Jenkins could be used for continuous integration and as well as continuous delivery or deployment. When I say delivery or deployment, basically it means that whatever you have built and tested and now is ready has to then move into your production. That's your continuous delivery. Configuration management. So whatever code you have built, you need infrastructure, you need configuration to, you know, spin up your infrastructure and manage the state of that infrastructure so that your code could run. So configuration management uses tools like Chef, Ansible, Puppet, and basically it manages and maintains the state of your system. Whatever requirements are there to run this code will be managed by your configuration management. It is very closely linked with infrastructure as a code, but it's not very similar. We'll cover that very soon. So after configuration management, another thing which you need to learn is containerization and orchestration, because obviously you will be containerizing your apps, you would be building your Docker files, you would be pushing your images into your container registries, and then Kubernetes kind of platforms will orchestrate all these containers and manage it. And that's why I say that in DevOps, there are multiple streams which could be created in itself as a career. Kubernetes, it's such a big and vast field that someone only focuses on being a Kubernetes developer or a Kubernetes administrator. And there are certifications focusing specially on Kubernetes. So yes, and all these things are in no particular order, guys. It's just that it is an organic flow of things how you need to learn. Coming to infrastructure as a code, I said configuration management and infrastructure as a code is very closely linked. So configuration management basically focuses on maintaining the configuration of your whole system. For example, if you have said that this particular VM or cluster should always have three nodes running all the time, something like that. Okay, so for that you will set up your configuration, and that configuration will continuously be monitored on your actual system. Infrastructure as a code is closely linked, but this is primarily focusing on deploying your infrastructure. Whatever you want to deploy, you will create a code. Terraform is a very famous product in the market, which helps you create a code in a very simple language, a JSON kind of a language, wherein you just put in what you need, you create those templates, and those templates will automatically spin up the machines on your cloud platforms automatically. And it closely works with your Chef, Ansible, Puppet, so that the state is maintained. Monitoring and logging, Prometheus and Grafana are two of the major products which are used there. So basically, monitoring and logging is self-explanatory. You need to monitor your whole DevOps pipeline and highlight any issues which crops up. Collaboration. So everything which you are doing in DevOps will eventually be running under a project, for example. And that project would most probably be an agile project. So where you would manage your agile development lifecycle, you would be running platforms like Jira, to run your Scrum projects, and then you would use products like Confluence for collaboration, for documenting whatever you are doing right now. So these are some products which you need to learn then. And lastly, security and compliance. So you need to understand what is encryption, how identity and access management works, and all those kind of things. You need to know the compliance as well. Container security, what level of security has to be implemented at a container level. All those kind of things come in this. So as I said, guys, you know, there are multiple layers and it might seem too much. But as I said, you don't need to be an expert in everything, and whichever course you will enroll into will make sure that you get enough understanding of it so that you can start participating on live projects, and then you will learn more. And I have intentionally kept very minimal products, famous products, because if you just focus on the tooling part of DevOps, you will be burnt out. It is massive. The whole umbrella, every one is, you know, every day you are getting a new product in one of these areas. So it's practically impossible for me to cover it in my small whiteboard, but then you could do your own research. You will easily find, and maybe if I have, I might put something in the description as well. At this point of time, I assume that, okay, we have completed our DevOps journey. We have completed everything. What next? Once we have learned everything, what comes post DevOps, which is the most important part, guys. So let's see that. So guys, coming to the most important phase, which is post DevOps. So I'm assuming that now we have done everything to say that, okay, we now know DevOps to an extent. It could be 6 out of 10 or 7 out of 10, but we feel we are ready. At that point of time comes the post DevOps phase, and it has to start with a relevant market certification. You need to get certified, and don't rush for certification right at the beginning. First, try to understand this, try to get into a live project, do hands-on, try to join a good training program, and then only go, because there's no point of certification, guys, if you can't justify it in an interview. Okay, the interviewer will very quickly understand that you have just mugged up and you're just calling out names. So don't do that. AWS certified DevOps engineer, Google Cloud professional DevOps engineer is there, these two certifications, and then there are multiple. Certified Kubernetes administrator, this could complement very well with, if you want to get into the Kubernetes part of it, or maybe you could do it along with your DevOps engineer certification. It is a very good complement to have. CKD is similar, certified Kubernetes developer. Again, a very good certification. You need to understand that in this whole DevOps journey, from where you are coming, what is your background? Are you coming from a developer background, or are you coming from a support or an infrastructure background? Based on that, your whole approach will vary, and the areas you focus on will vary. Okay, so if you are a support guy, you might find Kubernetes, or a Linux guy, then you might find Kubernetes administration more interesting, while if you are a developer, you might go into the developer kind of a road. Second thing, always be on your toes. Now, this is the first time I'm saying something non-technical, but this is by far the most important thing, because DevOps moves so fast that sometimes even after having all the skills, you might feel that you are yet to learn so much. So that's why you need to be very, very active. You need to continuously look for new learning opportunities, see what's there in the market, and continuously learn, because journey has not ended here. And a very important point, if you see, I have put a flag here, but I haven't put a flag here, which is to indicate that post DevOps, there is no end. So you need to continuous learn, you need to continuous grow. Now, the third step complements the step two, which is always being on your toes. And how you will do it? You will do it using actively participating in your online communities for DevOps. You will understand what's happening, what is in the market, what is hot in the market, what kind of challenges other engineers are facing. So you have to participate and you have to learn. Fourth is very important. Again, try to join a DevOps team in whatever capacity possible. So don't look for a perfect DevOps role in a company or in a team. Even if you are starting out, even if you are at a before DevOps stage, try to get into a DevOps team, maybe as a tester or maybe as a Scrum Master, for example, if you are a non-technical guy. Try to understand how a DevOps team works. The moment you become a part of that whole team and the whole culture, you will automatically learn a lot of tools automatically. There's no rocket science. You just need to do things hands-on. And fifth one, I will end with this one. It is very important, guys. You need to find a good mentor or a coach who could handhold you on this journey. Because in this journey, I'm talking about almost 6 months to 12 months journey, guys. It's not a 1 month program which you would do very quickly. It's a long journey. There would be times where you would dip, where you would feel like I am not going to do it. It's so much. I'm leaving it out. And at that point of time, you need a mentor or a coach to handhold you, to tell you that it's okay to be not okay. Okay. So for that, you need a mentor and a coach. So do find one. And if you are lucky enough, you'll get one. So friends, I hope you got something out of this video. If it added any value, please give it a like. Subscribe to ITK Funday channel because we make IT interesting for everyone. Hit the bell icon so you exactly know when I upload my next video, guys. And let me know in the comments what you would want to learn next. So until next time, guys, as we always say, keep learning, keep sharing all your knowledge, and yes, keep hustling. Bye for now.